What is up, y'all? Welcome back to the 805 Sneaker Podcast.
All right, bro. I got a big question for you. How do you feel about people that say resellers are ruining the sneaker
game?
Yeah, just get your insight from it.
I think resellers, if you think of it, you kind of make the market, you know what I mean?
Like,
they kind of set the prices and whatever. So like shoes itself, it's all like kind of social proof. You know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like if a shoe goes for $1,000, then that's because people think it's worth that much. Mm-hmm. And if there weren't any resellers, definitely prices for shoes would be a lot lower, but the market wouldn't be justified like that. There would be no kind of like the culture of it.
Yeah.
Like trading shoes, selling shoes.
Like you know how much a shoe is worth
exactly,
by
looking
at like this fool got the Trap 4s.
Yeah.
You know how
you're
much
like,
they go
oh,
for,
yeah,
you get me?
1K, yeah.
So you kind of get, and it kind of gives you an idea like, damn, that fool's got nice kicks.
Yeah, exactly,
you
yeah.
So no, I actually,
like,
that's,
if you know kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you think about it, like without resellers, like, reselling never existed. There'd be no like StockX,
Mike
Go, and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it'd be, because
they
wouldn't be as big as they are.
They wouldn't be
at
all without resellers.
Yeah, because if you think about it, like resellers, like they run the prices.
Yeah,
like,
they
run the
like,
game.
Like,
yeah.
Market, like market wise, they set the prices.
Exactly.
For sure.
So, I think it's beneficial, but I could see to the point where botters, like people say, like botters kind of ruin the game.
Yeah, botters.
Yeah,
do.
That
botters,
does suck.
That's different. Yeah,
they be getting like
they take every
clips of pairs, bro.
Yeah.
And like at that point, it's like damn, they're just trying to come up on like, profit.
Right.
And I really enjoy the shoe, you know what I mean?
It depends on what shoes too. Like I saw Soul Resell, bro.
Uh-huh.
He had a bunch of Grinch Kobe's. I'm like, bro, you can't be doing that.
I saw that.
Yeah,
bro.
I'm like, you can't
be
doing that.
Big advocate for like.
He almost finessed my guy over here.
Yeah, he did.
Really?
You see the video, bro? Yeah. He offered Cool Grey. My homie had Cool Grey 11s.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he was listing him for $220.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, he offered him $60.
What?
Yes. Straight
what?
Up. Straight up. He was like, "How much you want for these?" And he said,
"Was he recording?"
I was recording, bro. I got it. I was like, he was like, "Oh, $220." And it was like $60. And
what
bro,
the?
My homie,
he's like, meet me halfway.
Yeah, no, right. No, my homie was like, he's like a big fan of him too. Like watching videos,
so
he knows better.
Yeah,
and it's like, nah, I can't do that, bro. Like he's getting robbed. Dude.
Oh my god.
I know, but that's how he makes his money. Like,
bro, that's awesome though, because I always when I watch his videos, I'm like, bro, I want to see this fool try this shit on me.
Yeah,
I want to see it.
I know. He's lucky it wasn't my pair. I was like, I would be like, bro, are you kidding me? Like,
bro, actually, I don't think you probably don't remember, but the first time I met you was actually at the vintage. I was going for the, you had a pair of, I don't know if it was you or your homie, because someone else sells with you, right?
Yeah,
he had a pair of the Spidey joints,
the 9.5s. I know.
Yes.
The ones,
because he the ones, bro,
dude,
he
and
had them up for a pretty
you told
price.
Me about those,
yeah,
right?
And he gave me a good and he gave me a good offer
good.
Too
I remember that, and you were thinking about it,
yeah,
like,
it was funny as hell too, bro, because I think I was talking to him, and then you popped up, like, hyping up your man. You're like, sheesh!
Yeah, I had to, bro. But it was a good deal, that's why.
Yeah, it was.
He
it
was.
Was
telling me about the asking prices he was listing him at, and, like, he went, like, 100 under.
I was on Go. I was on Go. And
you're like,
fuck.
Shit.
And I was telling my girl, I'm like, man, that's a good deal.
Yeah.
Because I'm having a daughter next month.
Oh,
so
really?
She's due next
month.
Thanks, bro.
Dope.
And we got her a little pair of the Spidey joints. I'm like, fuck,
you
now
gotta
I
got
to get a pair for me to match it up. So I was on I've been on the hunt for that pair.
Yeah, for that pair, huh?
Yeah,
he still has them? Yeah,
damn.
I don't know how much he's trying to get rid of.
Might have to hit him up, we'll see.
All right, bro. I have another question.
What's up?
We all know you have a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
How has that been so far?
YouTube, it's been crazy, bro, because I've always wanted to get into YouTube, but I think on YouTube you need a niche to kind of get popping. Like,
definitely.
You need like a certain type of style of videos or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And like just sneakers as a hobby, like it's just something I wanted to like record and document, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So just from that, it's been cool. Like I just hit 1,000 subs.
Yo, that's
like,
dope.
Turn up. And it's just weird to say, because like I would watch YouTubers before and be like, damn, they have a bunch of subs, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like they put in work and whatnot, and then like here I am. Well, I mean 1,000 is not a lot, but like it took
that
a while to get to, and it's like it's pretty dope.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
I'm trying to build
Congrats,
on that
bro.
Too. Thank you. Yeah.
That's dope, bro.
Bro. Hell yeah.
Yeah, no, it's
yeah.
pretty dope. Yeah.
I seen your video. It was like how to get Depop famous or some shit.
Oh yeah.
I see. I watched that video.
Hey,
I watched it, bro.
Hey,
I was watching, bro.
I love hearing that, bro. It's so weird to hear. It's
bro,
like, you watch my video?
No, I was selling. I was.
Did you
bro,
like it though?
Hell, I liked
did
it. I subscribed, bro.
Did
I did all my thing, bro. I didn't comment. I should have commented.
Okay,
nah, bro, actually, your video did help me a lot,
bro.
Because I've always sold on
it.
Depop. I've sold on Mercari. Like, I actually have a lot of feedback on it, like, a lot.
Yeah.
And, but one thing
like
that I was lacking was consistency on my page.
Yeah.
And you were talking about the pictures. Remember that?
Yeah,
you were talking about that.
Uh-huh.
And that actually helped me a lot. So now my page is much more organized now. Bro, it's all same background. I'm glad it looks clean, bro. So you did help, bro.
That's dope. Yeah, definitely. That's one of the main things. Like on Depop, like for people that don't really know about it, like it's a good selling medium to start because it's basically Instagram, but a selling app. So like it's all aesthetic wise. Like you can get popping on Depop just from like making your feed look nice.
Looking nice,
being active, like doing what you do on Instagram, but on there.
Yeah.
So yeah, I started selling on that. When did you start?
Depop, bro, I've been selling here and there because I'm not a hardcore reseller, bro. It's just pretty much when I get over a shoe, I sell it.
I feel that,
So I just sell on, I just probably over a year now. Okay. I've sold, like, I think on Depop, I probably have like 30 of the feedback.
You sold a lot, then.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, here and there. I try emptying out like anything I don't wear in my closet. I don't like clutter. But then at the same time, I don't want to just take it to the thrift store and not get money back. Exactly, I'm kind of weird. Bro, like, I want, like, I don't even care if it's $10. I want
it. That's my issue, bro.
I don't know. I'm just like that. I don't want to just get rid of shit.
Yeah, no, I feel the same way. That's why Depop is perfect to dump. Because, like, people go on there to look for old stuff.
Like, vintage shit,
old stuff on there that people still buy. You
know? For sure, whenever I'm looking for, like, vintage tees, I go on Depop.
You go on Depop.
Yeah, because, like, if you go on Mercari or Poshmark, you won't find them. Depop, it's different.
It's a different kind of demographic.
It's a vibe, and they're all super cool, man. Yeah. I think out of all of them, I think Depop's the spot where everyone's super nice.
Everyone's
super nice.
It's a family, bro.
How do you feel about, like, obviously, we've heard all about, like, Warren Lotus and shit. Like, he started off just as a brand, bro. Right?
Yeah, that's a good...
He started off as just a brand.
I heard that he was actually on Discord groups and he was just chopping up, making graphics for them. Yeah. And then the graphics were so good that he popped off and like artists
did his own thing.
He did his own thing.
That shit's hard.
And his designs are
They're nutty.
I have a jersey.
The Lakers one? Oh, the Rockets one?
Lakers one is fire. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. With the skull and
And it's got LeBron on it.
Those designs are crazy. But quality wise, I think like especially with the case with the Nike SBs, you know what I mean? I have a feeling like he doesn't actually like authenticate, like it's not authentic stuff, you know what I mean? It's kind of like reps quality, but it's just the brand, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
It's crazy to see how much he's
and his shit goes for bread too,
like that jersey's $200, bro. Like,
damn,
and he sells out. That's the thing, he sells out like every drop.
Damn,
yeah.
People want his shit then,
yeah. No, people want his stuff. It just has a cult like fan base,
definitely.
You know?
Yeah,
that's what you need sometimes.
How do you feel about like bootleg? Because like bootleg, they're not the only ones. Like, I don't know if you guys have seen Obra IP. Have you seen that?
Yeah, I've seen.
Fugazi.
Oh yeah, yeah.
The ones, the bullet hole ones.
Yeah, because like some are hard.
Those are fire.
Some are hard, bro.
I was gonna try to come up on a pair.
Yeah, would you say they're fakes or would you say they're just? It's a little different, right?
Yeah, I would say. I think it's the way you manufacture you know what I mean? Because, like, it's their own design.
Yeah.
And, like, if they get a manufacturing in a legit warehouse, it's just a copycat design. Mm-hmm. Same silhouette, but I wouldn't say they're fake. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They are bootleg, yeah.
Yeah. But, like, if you know what you're wearing, it's kind of like you know what you're wearing.
It's like, you rock it, then it's cool.
Yeah, because, like, if you're out on the street, you see someone wearing some Warren Lotto dunks, you're not going to be like, those are fake. You're going to be like, you're probably going to start talking about fucking Warren Lotto. It's a conversation starter. I mean, now I think any Warren Lotto dunks, like those first ones that came out, are kind of special now.
Yeah.
Because we're not going to see the new ones. I had got the Stussy dunks.
Tell me why they just popped on my page.
That's kind of scary, bro.
That's weird. I got the Warren Lotto version of those.
I
never got them because of the lawsuit.
And then they try to offer you
the ugly ass one. You know what's funny, bro? I never rejected it and I never accepted it either. I just went straight to PayPal. I was like, yo, I want my money back. They gave me my money back. And I still get emails from Warren saying your order is still in process.
Oh, what?
So, hey, who knows? I might end up getting them, bro. I mean, we'll see. I mean, PayPal got my back. They got me my money back already. So
that's dope.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So we'll see how that goes. Straight, man. It's been real, man.
Yeah, man. It's been an honor, for real, being the first guest on the show.
Yeah, bro.
You're doing big things.
Yeah, bro. You were a great guest, man. It was great chopping it up today.
Yeah, no, it was fun. It was dope, dude.
Good stories.
Yeah.
Anything else? Anything you wanted to plug today?
Plug? Just like, comment, subscribe on my channel.
Oh, you on that YouTube?
Yeah, I'm on that YouTube grind. So
yeah, go ahead, bro.
Subscribe. Prescription Kicks on YouTube, bro. You know. Follow me on IG and whatnot. Follow the 805 Sneaker Podcast. Stream them everywhere.
Appreciate you.
Apple Music, all that. Follow Skepto Shop.
Yes, sir.
Get those shots.
Yes, sir.
Cup of tea or something. You know
hell
what I mean?
Yeah.
Yo.
Yeah. Follow my boys and stuff. So
that's
yeah,
love.
It was an honor.
All right, y'all. Thanks for listening, y'all. Peace out. Until the next one.
Later.
Yes, sir.
Later. Later.
This shit died, right?
Yeah.
I think it died.
Bro, bro, the audio sounds fucking funky right now.
It does, yeah. When you were talking, it sounded like a little staticky.
Oh,
really?
For real?
Yeah.
Really?
Cool. I don't know. I'm gonna call Amazon today, bro.
Why?
Because I'm gonna fucking get a new one.
Oh.
How much are they in Best Buy?
For 200.
That shit was 200?
This shit's 200.
That shit is 200.
Bro,
that shit is worth no more than at least 50 bucks.
Bro.
Right?
Oh.
Fuck, we missed all that.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
Let's just do it really quick. All
right.
It's not gonna sound as natural though, because we already went over it.
Like, oh, really?
Just redo that shit real quick.
Let's do it real quick.
I just got the Fragment 3s, actually. I got
Fragment 3s?
Yes, sir. Just BS them just recently. So
nice, bro.
Yes,
I actually have a pair of them that stock. Yeah, man.
Y'all,
I can't do it. We're acting now, bro.
We got lines, we got a script.
No, let's go back to it.
We're gonna have like 30 of these takes right here. No, that's not gonna go right.
Fragment 3s.
Oh, yeah.
No, wait, Fragment 3s? I didn't even know. I didn't see them, bro. Fuck.
I wanna see like some Air Monarchs. Some off-white Air Monarchs. I want to see it.
Statue.
I want to see. I think Virgil's thought about it, bro. I know Virgil's out here.
Air Monarchs.
Hell yeah, bro. Barbecue grilling, bro. I damn well know Virgil's out here like, fuck, man. I'm gonna do it for the dads, bro. I'm gonna do it for them.
Fuck no.
We'll see, man. Don't be surprised, bro.
Damn, no.
You wear him if he gives you all black Air Forces with the S on it.
With the S on him,
bro. I get sued, no cap.
Bro, if you get sued, that means you made it, bro. That means you made it.
And then I'm like.